3, 2, 1.
Now, Churchill is gigantic in history. He's beloved. He's got this kaleidoscope of qualities. He almost embodies what's left of the British Empire.
This nation needs a strong, experienced administration.
So I was thrilled and terrified when I was offered the role.
So, shall we make a start?
Yes.
When John was cast, I just thought it was absolutely genius. His accent, the way he moves, his humour, he is just brilliant.
There comes a time where one must draw a line in the sand.
And the job of drawing that line falls to Cabinet, ma'am, not to you. Something your dear late papa would certainly have taught you had he been granted more time to complete your education.
It was pretty inspirational, a bit of casting. By coming at it from an American perspective, John Lithgow would bring something different to it.
I was just fascinated to see what John Lithgow's Churchill would be like. And what hair and makeup has done brilliantly, I think, is give you an essence of Winston Churchill rather than it being a lookalike.
Every morning, we have this quick transformation. We have a couple of little secrets, things inside my mouth and inside my nose, and a brilliant wig. And before we could fit any clothes, we had to build the body first. And building the body took a long time.
We talked about the shape we wanted to create and looked at a lot of pictures, and so we created a padding. But actually, as John has become the character, he's almost contorted himself into the shape.
That's got it. I think I'm true to his spirit. I know I'm not going to duplicate him. There's no one like Winston Churchill. I just have to make it real.
I have witnessed scenes here today, the likes of which we have not seen since the darkest days of the Blitz. But alongside the suffering, I've also seen heroism. And where there is heroism, there will always be hope. Thank you all.